Dear learners, welcome you all to the introduction class of the first unit, Advertising Management. In this session, I'll be giving the intro, what we are going to discuss in the introduction class of Unit 1. Okay, so the Unit 1 already I discussed, so these are the contents. We'll be discussing about the definition, classification of advertisement, functions and benefits, and impact on children and women, and social and economic benefits with the regulatory bodies regulating advertisements. Okay, so promotion. We know promotion is a way of communication. So promotion, otherwise we call this a persuasive communication or a marketing communication. We only use the word in HR to promote means moving from one level to the next level. But in marketing, we speak of promotion means we are creating an awareness to reach the product, the all minds, target audience. It's mainly focused on informing. After the informing, that's the creation of awareness. We have to persuade them. It's not just getting the news about the brand and product. We have to create an interest. And finally, we have to convince the target audience. So even in the sales management or marketing, these things can be a different steps, but the promotion takes all the steps together and convince the customers to buy the product, enjoy the product, and feel happy about using the product. So the major objectives of the promotion is inform, persuade, and even you are buying the product, we have to remind that you are buying the right product. If you forget to buy the product, the advertisement will remind you, please buy the product, please stick on with the brand. And in this promotion, we are adopting the two models. One is AIDA, attention, interest, and desire and action. Another one is called as AIETA, HR model. Maybe awareness or attention, interest, evaluation, and trial and action. So two models we already discussed in the marketing management. So the nature of promotion is it's information-oriented, awareness creation process, persuasion process. It motivates the customer to think about the product, try the product, buy the product, use the product, retain, and feel happy, stay loyal. And it tries to avoid the brand switching. So even there are some minor challenge or issues or shortage of satisfaction, the advertisement will convince you stay back and avoid brand switching to the customers. So the promotion mix, we have many mix. Out of that, first and foremost mix we are going to study in the subject is advertisement. Advertisement is defined by, underline the word, any paid form of. We say advertisement, it should be any paid form of. Non-personal presentation. In the advertisement, we should not speak about our personal, our privacy. It is mainly for selling or promoting a product or people or even. So it is a non-personal presentation. That means it can be available to public or target audience, and it involves the promotion of ideas, goods, services. And this advertisement has to be launched and reach the end consumer through a proper sponsor. So we are dividing the heading, definition of advertisement is it should have a paid form. The content of the advertisement should be non-personal, and its objective is to promote ideas or physical goods or intangible services, and it should be done through a proper identified sponsor. So this is a small definition of advertisement. So advertisement can be a visual or can be oral or can be any way. So advertising mainly focus to turn the mind toward means towards the product, towards the brand. Okay. Yes. If you are able to see an advertisement, or if you already seen an advertisement, can you able to recollect a message what it gave, what are the medium they used, who may be the target audience for that ad, and the particular target audience, how they are behaving in the buyer adoption stat categories, what are the appeal they used in the advertisement, what are the model they used, how reach it is, and what will the ad effectiveness. So these things we have to think while seeing an advertisement. So advertisement is having strategy, and advertisement is having a different types that we'll be discussing one by one in the forthcoming unit. So while we're classifying the advertisement, it can be a print media, which involves newspaper, magazine, journals, etc. It can be a broadcast media like a radio, television, etc. It can be a website or internet blogging. It can be specifically for television ads using audiovisual technique to appeal to customers. It can be using a mobile ads, mobile phone, using a text or pictures or multimedia. Or it can be a non-broadcast media like cinema theaters or cable TV, etc. It's not actually broadcast to public. Outdoor advertisement, another category. Okay, so you may be seeing the posters, you may be seeing the billboards, you may be seeing banners, etc. Another one or type of advertising is the transit advertisement, that is advertising in a transit area where there is a more movement of people or their vehicle or there, like a bus stand and nearby subways and railways stations. Like that, here we can see a lot of advertisement in the transit place. That's called as transit advertisement. Sometimes we can send a mail individually to the targeted customer. So these are the few types of advertisements. So already we know the AIDA model, and the very important another one model is called as a DOGMOR. DOGMOR means defining advertising goals for measured advertising results. So this says that we should have a proper objective and we have to work on it. And if you are adding an advertisement with this, we should be able to measure what is the advantage we had, what is the additional result we are getting. So DOGMOR is defining advertising goals for measured advertising results. So we'll be doing some activity with respect to that in learning classification of advertisement, and we'll be discussing why children has to be used to properly in the advertisement, or the advertisement should keep in mind that advertisement may be viewed by children, and how badly or positively women are utilized in promotion using advertisement, either as a celebrity or as an act or whatever it may be, how the woman or used in the advertisement. So we have to discuss whether it is a positive or negative thing. And we'll be discussing when there is an advertisement happening, there will be a sales, when there is a sale, there will be a turnover, then there is a turnover, there will be more job opportunities will be there, many people are ready to spend, there is a circulation will be there. This is one concept. So we may be discussing about the socio and economic effects of advertisement, and whatever we prepare, we cannot post in the common forum. So is there any regulatory body to regulate what has to be posted, what should not be posted? Okay, so these things we'll be discussing in the unit one, in the first session. Okay, so while we are coming to the next classes, we will have different activities, and be ready and keep your brain ready for the creativity and innovation. So we will rock soon. Thank you, dear students. Please take care.